All right, so it's been a couple of months since I've been to the fish store, maybe like a month. Just came in town, got a haircut, figured I'm gonna stop in here, have a peek around right quick, see if there's anything new, anything that we need. I do have a few ideas of some stuff that I'd like to probably pick up, but for the most part, there's a few exciting things I want to show you. With a couple of new tanks I'm setting up, I wanna do something very specific. I think I wanna do a hardscape with just rock, maybe pile it up really high, but I gotta find a rock that's actually going to match the background that I currently have in there, and it's kind of reddish brownish. I think this is kind of the, you know, the closest rock to it, which is a maple leaf rock. So I don't know how much is in there or if it'd be enough, but a bunch of different types of aquascaping rocks. I really like this stuff too. And then, of course, your lava rock, which might be a pretty good idea, but I don't know, what do you guys think? With that background, should I go this one or this one? And then substrate, I think I'll go a dark substrate again, maybe this black stuff here. We did that before, that's good. Lots of wood. I need no wood. I need no wood whatsoever. But there is plenty of it here. Nice little selection of it. Lots of frags for salt water. Look at the clown trigger. These guys are absolutely, absolutely gorgeous. This looks like a fish that was like painted. The triggers are probably some of the most bizarre, you know, colorways and just combinations. They just make me speechless every time. I don't even know what to say about them. Absolutely beautiful. If there's any other cool guy. That puffer's gone, I think. Somebody picked it up. Oh,
who are you? What's your name?
Let me see here. Yeah, I think the puffer's gone. Unless he's hiding somewhere. I'm not sure. I like that they have them separated with the egg crate. Such a cost-effective way to do that. Smaller fish can swim in and out, stay protected, whereas the bigger fish are isolated. Really interesting. Lots of plants. I'm gonna need a lot of plants here shortly. I think they're just digging through this, a little foggy. But do I do plants in that tank? Ooh, I like that rock right there too. Ooh, I really like that rock. Look at that color. Interesting stuff. Wow. For those that never seen seam injected silicone, what they'll do is, you can see them in the corners here, see that little dot? That's a silicone spacer, where they'll put the silicone spacer there and probably, yeah, right at the bottom here, and then along the entire seams, and that will create a bit of a space for it to inject the silicone directly, so there's a bit of a buffer. That's how you do that. Let's see what else we got in here. Gotta look in every tank, otherwise you might skip by a little treasure. Electric bluejack dempsey, Florida crayfish, bright orange. He looks like he wants to hug me. I think he does want to hug me. He wants to come over. He's like a little kid that wants to be picked up and taken home. You might have to come home. Look how excited he is. He's like, take me, please. I've never kept a crayfish before. Lots of shrimp, but never a crayfish. Look at the white one. The lights are off in this tank. Oh, there's all kinds of white ones. Aw. They're so cute. Do you want a hug? Yeah, he wants a hug. You want a hug? He does too. Aw. So cute. This is usually where they hide the cool plecos or lay. There's a little bristle nose back there. Get this rock out of the way.
You see why they're called a bristlenose? I think it's a bristlenose anyways, yeah?
Let's see what else we got in here. Nice piranha. A piranha, single piranha. Something about that size was my first fish ever, but it was a red belly that I had. So a lot of people ask what these were. in the last video, I told them it was like a miniature arowana type thing. Let me see if I can get that to focus. Jeez. They do kind of look like tiny little arowana. It's a panchax. Here's the actual proper name. And they're actually quite affordable too. Pretty cool little fish. The reflection's killing me. Those are really cool. Some angels. Ooh, these are pinoys. Aren't they nice? What do you guys think? Do you think I should add more angels to my tank? Mine were about this size when I got them. Should we vary it up? A bunch of red Oscars. Nice. Oh, this big fella's still here. That's a, I always think that everybody watches every video. That's a Severum or Severum. Depends on how you want to pronounce it. I'll get taken apart in the comments for not pronouncing everything exactly how everybody pronounces them. Look how big they get. That's a big boy. He's way bigger than he looks. Salt water. Is that a wrasse? So pretty. Marine betta. Oh, aren't you gorgeous? Everybody wants me to start a betta tank. I should do one of those. Where'd he go? Isn't he pretty? He's so gorgeous. A little shy, though. A little shy. But he wants to keep an eye on me. Isn't he pretty? Arowana. These are silver arowanas. These are the true beasts of the arowana family. A depth of around 4 feet. Some parrots. The size of that pleco. See, at this size, they stop really eating algae because they can't get enough nutrition from the algae. They're so big, so they start eating what the other fish are eating, and they're no longer, you know, that algae eater keeping the tank as clean. And they get so much bigger than that. So much bigger. Probably the most returned fish in the hobby is the pleco, the common pleco, the postumus. Some Africans here. Ooh, the Malawi blue dolphins. So these guys are going to get really nice as they get older. Really, really nice. I like the simple ones too, where they're a solid color. See, these could probably pass as a saltwater fish, some of them, right? Like little tiny damsels type of thing. They get bigger. Mm, beautiful. Feed up for these guys. Fancy long fin. I'm not a fan of this. I don't like it. I like the common body shape, right? This is pretty cool, and I know it's a lot of people love it, but I like this. Same with the longfin Oscar. Not a fan of the longfin Oscar. I like their classic shape. Not only because it's a classic shape, but it's like what they're known for is those paddle fins. The tail fin. Ooh, lots of pretty bettas. Look at you. You're too pretty. Yeah, you're sold. Don't blame you. What are you guys doing? They're so tiny. How are you doing, pretty? Hmm. Maybe I do need a betta. I better get a betta. I don't know what I want. I wish I could. I want the 120 is big enough probably for a bunch of males to go in it and get along. I would, or maybe do one female and, or I'm sorry, one male and like 20 females. I don't see any females here. I like this system though. Go back. These tanks tend to be like quarantine and rescues and whatnot, but every once in a while, ooh, look at all the clowns. I know Bulk Resupply did a harem clown tank. I think Mark Levinson has one too. I think they're awesome. Love them. Love them, love them, love them. Let's see what else is in here. Come on. What do we got here? Some koi. Sorted koi. Interesting. Pond season's coming, so koi are going to start popping up in the stores. Another giant pleco down there. Goldfish. Are those apple snails? I should get some. I should get a little bit of everything. I've decided. Dragoons. I like how it's so quiet here. I can think. I got some of you guys, the barbs. They look a lot different here because of the lighting. I'm switching my lighting back up again. By the way, we're gonna go back to those,
horse faces. These guys are cool.
Some exodons. Really interesting. What else we got here? Ooh, wait till we get to the back. I know there's something there. Oh, look at you.
You chubby wubby.
No more. Damn, no more of them. Another one. It's a red Texas, though. That's not a flower horn. I'm gonna point that out. That's pretty. A flower horn. So, flower horn, I see it as the king of the island. Look at all the babies. That's Francine's baby. Could have been Frank's. Imagine if Frank had babies. He would have broke the internet. Kardashians would have been so jealous. I would not blame them. Aw, flower horn. Because I put Francine Fry. Mm-hmm. So cute. Molly's. Lunar silver dollars. I think we showed these in a past video. Oh man, silver dollars are so slept on. They're so big. These guys are really different though. See the patterning on them? Really pretty. I like them a lot. Some discus, nice little variety there. Oh, we got a leporinus.
How do you pronounce that?
Leporinus. Leporinus. I know what it is, and I can see the name in my head, but I can never say it. A little banged up. A little banged up, but he's a big guy. He's gonna freak out and, you know, knock a filter over or something here and there. He's pretty, isn't he? Alright, one more row. These gotta be breeders almost. Look at that. That's definitely a male. See the nuchal hump on that, angel? Yeah, it's difficult to see in this tank. Where'd he go? Yeah. These guys are breeding size. See the nuchal hump? The forehead on him? What a weird looking angel. Wow. Interesting. What's he got in here? Looks like these guys were cleared out a little while ago. Oh, very pretty. Very nice. That's what I need. I need a tank of these guys. Change the lighting there. Very pretty, isn't it? I like those. Very nice. Yeah, so this is a really high energy video. I'm just having a peek around, seeing what's here. I like to do this, and I thought I'd just bring you guys along for today, because I got a busy day ahead of me. I'm not going to be able to make a regular video, so why not just come along to the pet store with me, right? You guys like this? Let me know. Leave the video a thumbs up. Like these mellow joeys. Just a trip. Tricolor sword tails. They're always bringing in something a little bit different every time. Staying consistent with a lot of things, but ooh, the white cloud minnow. Such a classic. I almost want to do a tank of these guys too. Very nice. Sorry this is on my phone, guys. I wasn't, you know, ready to film or wanting to film. Pearl Grommies did these before. So dark. It is dark back here. There's no lights on. So I'm doing my best with my phone. Zebra danios. These were one of my first fish too. We used to have a community tank with danios and angels and ballas and grommies. A lot of fish that should probably not do well together, but heck, they did okay in my tank. Some cardinals. Those neons below. Oh, nice contrast. So we've got the neon below. We'll take a closer look at the cardinals here. So cardinals have their red from all the way from the back to the front of their gill plates. and then the neons, just almost like half their body is just red, the bottom half. Cardinals also get bigger. Price will be a little more expensive for cardinals versus the neons, and I believe neons are no longer wild caught, but I believe most cardinal tetras that you have will be wild caught. A lot of people don't know this. Like, a lot of fish are still not breeding, being bred in captivity in numbers to support the hobby. But I could be wrong here. I just know that every time I see cardinals available, they're always wild caught. Tiger Hill stream loach. Zoom in on him. Looks like a little baby stingray, doesn't he? Interesting. Oh, there's the front of one. Look. So you get this. And this video quality is horrible compared to a normal camera. There's the back. Front. That's cool, right? So these are their dopsy fins, or dopsy fins, and their pectoral fins that have adapted to kind of suck them to fast flowing areas where they'll suck to a rock or whatever.
Don't blow away.
Final corridor. Blowfish. What else we got here?
What else?
Ooh. Snake skin tuxedo guppies. Too cool. I do kind of want to do guppies too. But now that I'm looking at the mollies and swordtails, maybe we should do that. Get out of the way, Nathan. We're filming.
Oh, sorry.
Ooh, missed you. So that would have been a blood parrot at one point. Eventually, they go from that dark red coloration and they lose it over time. Turn pink. Some green terrors. Had these guys before, too. I don't find them to be as ostrous or as violet as a lot of other cichlids, but I do like their name. That's it. All right, that's it for today, folks. Hope you enjoyed the little quick tour. Let me know what you guys think. I'll see you guys in a couple of days.